Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create duplicates of objects using the copy tool and how to create a polar array using the array function in uMake. Let's start off by sketching a simple curve, and let's imagine I want to create a couple duplicates of this curve. Simply double tap to select this curve and then tap the copy button over here in the side menu. And now anytime I move this object, this curve, it can be a surface as well. Anytime I move this object, if I move it up like this, if I move it to the side, as long as copy is enabled, I am creating duplicates of the object. This works for rotating the object. So if I want to rotate this, I'm now creating a duplicate like that. It works for scaling as well. If I select this portion of the curve and scale this up, it's going to create a duplicate as well. So it's really helpful if you need to quickly create duplicates of an object, but it can sometimes get in the way if you forget to turn it off. So to turn off the copy function, simply tap copy one more time, and now it's off. I can take this selected object and move it in any way that I want and scale it or rotate it without creating a duplicate. If I want to create another duplicate of it, simply tap copy, move it, and you have another duplicate. So it's pretty simple. Just use it when you need it and make sure it's off when you don't need it. So let's turn that off. And now let's jump into the polar array tool. So I'm going to clean this up really quick. I'm going to come back over to the front view and I'm just going to sketch two curves. Something like that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both of the curves. I used the symmetry tool to sketch both of those curves at the same time. I turned symmetry off for this next step. So I'm going to select both curves like that, tap the array tool down here in the side menu, and you'll see that I have created several curves. Basically, they're the same curves and they are in a polar array. The center of this polar array is this little green dot, and I can actually grab that green dot and move it around like this, and I can change the polar array based on where I place this green dot, where I place the center of the polar array. So if I want to place it right here, I can get something that looks like that. If I want to move it straight down to the origin, like this, I have something that looks like that. So basically, you can move this center of the polar array in any direction. Now, I want to show you something really cool. I'm actually going to undo that, and I'm going to move both of these curves up just a little bit, and then I'm going to sketch a circle, and I'm going to snap this circle to the grid really quick. I just want to move this down. This is just for demonstration purposes. So I've snapped this circle down to the center, around this origin. And the reason I'm showing you this is when you have a circle, a circular curve, and you enable a polar array, so I'm going to select those two curves again, tap array. When you move this, the center of the array, it's going to automatically snap into the middle, the center point of a circle. So if I move this green circle down, you'll see that, you see that? It snaps to the middle of this circle. And that's really helpful for making things like watch faces, clock faces, vehicle wheels, etc. Anything that you need to have a polar array on, draw a circle around, and that will snap the center of the array to the middle of that circular curve. It's a really, really helpful hint. Once you've snapped the center of your polar array, you can change the number of copies that you want. So come over here, tap on the number, and you can slide this up. So there I have 9 copies of this spoke. I can go all the way up to 16. And you can also change the angle as well. So if I want 9 copies, I can have it in 180 degrees, 90 degrees, and 270. You can change the angle of the array. I'm going to go back to 360. Once you're done with your polar array, simply tap the green check mark, and you'll have duplicate copies of the initial objects that you selected. So that was these two curves here. duplicated in a polar array. So that's about it. I hope this tutorial was helpful and showed you how to use the copy tool and the array function. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, definitely let us know. You can find us on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We'd love to see what you create with these tools, and we can't wait to hear from you. Take care, guys.